Hi, this is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to study about electron transport chain. Also, it is called respiratory chain or cellular respiration because it utilizes oxygen. In short, we can call it as ETC. So when we say electron transport chain, that means there is transport of electrons across series of proteins or complexes which are located in inner mitochondrial membrane. So where these electrons are coming from? These electrons are donated by reducing equivalents, which we already studied in glycolysis and TCA cycle, where there is generation of reducing equivalents which carry high energy electrons in the form of NADH and FADH2. So these, you can see there is one hydrogen atom consists of one electron and one proton, that is H+. Similarly, FADH2 also contains proton and electron. So totally we have, from this NADH plus H+, we have two electrons and two protons. And similarly, FADH2 also has got two protons and two electrons. So those reducing equivalents which are generated as a result of glycolysis, as we know glycolysis takes place in cytoplasm, it will be transferred to mitochondrial matrix. And in TCA cycle, which already takes place in the mitochondrial matrix, where it generates NADH plus H+, and also FADH2. Now these reducing equivalents which carry electrons are transferred to this series of complexes which are located in inner mitochondrial membrane. So they looks like a chain. So this is called respiratory chain. Complex 1, complex 2, complex 3 and complex 4. Besides, there are electron carriers that we will be studying short moment from now. So the NADH plus H+ will be converted to NAD, and the two electrons are handover to the various complexes, and finally there is acceptor of this electrons, that is oxygen, and the energy utilized for the formation of ATP. So this formation of ATP is called oxidative phosphorylation because there is oxidation reduction reactions taking place inside the inner mitochondrial membrane. So I am going to make a separate video for oxidative phosphorylation. Today I am going to emphasize only electron transport chain. Similarly, the high energy electrons which are present in FADH2 are also handover to complex 2 of electron transport chain, and the electrons are transferred from different complexes, and finally there is generation of ATP. Before going to understand electron transport chain, you need to remember each NADH plus H+, after handovering its electrons to various complexes of respiratory chain, it will give 2.5 ATP. Similarly, each FADH2 will give 1.5 ATP. Now we will see the exact mechanism or pathway of ETC or electron transport chain or respiratory chain or cellular respiration. Here I have, because the component of electron transport chain are located in inner mitochondrial membrane, and synthesis of ATP or production of ATP occurs in the mitochondrial matrix. So this is outer mitochondrial membrane, because mitochondria has got two membrane, outer membrane and inner membrane. So this is our inner mitochondrial membrane, and this is the mitochondrial matrix. The in-between space between outer mitochondrial membrane and inner mitochondrial membrane is called intermembranous space. This space is very important when we are going to study oxidative phosphorylation, which I am going to explain in the next video. Now we have reducing equivalents in the mitochondrial matrix. They carry high energy electrons which can be handover to various components of electron transport chain. First, we will see the complex 1, which is located in the inner mitochondrial membrane. The NADH plus H plus converted to NAD so that it will hand over the 2 protons and 2 electrons to components of complex 1. Complex 1, it is a large protein. It has got FMN, that is flavin mononucleotide, which is present in oxidized form. This FMN acquires 2 protons and 2 electrons from NADH plus H plus. In turn, it will be converted to reduced FMN H2. This FMN H2 carries electron as well as protons from the reducing equivalent NADH plus H plus. Now this FMN H2 undergo oxidation back to FMN. Meanwhile, it will donate its 2 electrons to iron sulfur complexes which are present in the complex 1. There may be about 6 to 8 iron sulfur complexes, and each iron sulfur complex can take 1 electron at a time. But we have 2 electrons which are donated by NADH plus H plus. So I have written here 2 iron sulfur complex, which is present in oxidized form, where the iron is present in ferric form. So this undergo reduction, where 2 iron sulfur complex acquires 2 electrons from FMN H2, and the 2 protons are released into the medium. So we have reduced iron sulfur complex. So this high energy electron which are present in iron sulfur component hand over to an electron carrier called coenzyme Q. All the component of electron transport chain are protein except this coenzyme Q, which is derived from quinone, which is a fat soluble component. This coenzyme Q acquires these 2 electrons. Remember, these 2 electrons are coming from the reducing equivalent NADH plus H plus. And this coenzyme Q acquires these 2 protons and 2 electrons, and it will be reduced to QH2, that is reduced form of coenzyme Q. So while transferring electrons from one component to other component of complex 1, there is a release of energy. This energy pushes 4 photon from the mitochondrial matrix to the intermembranous space. Again, this information is very important when we are going to study oxidative phosphorylation, because these 4 protons actually makes 1 ATP that we are going to study in the next video. This is about complex 1. So this complex 1 is also called NADH coenzyme Q oxidoreductase. Now what is the fate of this reduced form of coenzyme Q, which is actually acts as an electron carrier? Now we have a complex 3 located in inner mitochondrial membrane. So this complex 3 contains heme-containing protein called cytochrome B, which is present in oxidized form. So it acquires 2 electrons from reduced coenzyme Q. In turn, it will become reduced cytochrome B. Again, this reduced cytochrome B of complex 3 handovers its high energy electron, that is 2 electrons, to oxidized iron sulfur complex, which are also present in complex 3. You can see iron sulfur complex is present in complex 1 and complex 3. So it is oxidized. Here iron is present in ferric form. So once it acquires electrons from reduced cytochrome B, it will be converted to reduced iron sulfur complex. Now this reduced iron sulfur complex handover its electron to oxidized cytochrome C1. Again it is a heme containing protein, cytochrome C1. So this oxidized cytochrome C1, after acquiring 2 electrons from this reduced iron sulfur complex, it will undergo reduced cytochrome C1. Now these 2 electrons are present in reduced cytochrome C1. Now again there is another electron carrier which is present in the inner mitochondrial membrane, which is called cytochrome C, which is present in oxidized form, so that it can acquire these 2 electrons which are present in the cytochrome C1. So in turn this cytochrome C will become reduced cytochrome C. Again in complex 3, the electrons are transferred from cytochrome B to iron sulfur complex to cytochrome C1. There is release of energy. So this energy utilized for the pumping of the 4 protons from mitochondrial matrix to the intermembranous space. So complex 1, there are pumping of 4 protons. Even in complex 3, pumping of 4 protons from the mitochondrial matrix to the intermembranous space. Now, what is the fate of this reduced cytochrome C? So this complex 3 is called cytochrome C oxidoreductase. Now, what is the fate of this reduced cytochrome C? There is another complex, that is complex 4, it is also called cytochrome oxidase, which is present in the inner mitochondrial membrane. So the 2 electrons which are present in the reduced cytochrome C handover to copper. Now you see the cytochrome B, which is a heme containing protein, whereas the complex 4, which is not an heme containing protein, which is actually a copper containing protein, cytochrome oxidase or complex 4. So this copper atom accepts 2 electrons and hand over to cytochrome A. Actually complex 4 is made up of 2 cytochromes, that is cytochrome A and cytochrome A3. Both are linked to copper. Cytochrome A linked to copper, we call it as copper A. Now this cytochrome A, which has got 2 high energy electrons, hand over to cytochrome A3, which is linked to copper, and this copper is called copper B. Finally, there is release of 2 electrons. Please appreciate carefully here, these 2 electrons are coming from this reducing equivalent NADH+H+. Now these 2 electrons hand over to the final acceptor, that is oxygen. That is why it is called cellular respiration or respiratory chain. So the ultimate goal is oxidation of foodstuff, that is carbohydrate or fatty acids or ketogenic amino acids. They are finally oxidized in presence of oxygen. So one atom of oxygen and 2 protons and these 2 electrons. So 2 electrons and 2 protons will make 2 hydrogen atom and 1 oxygen atom. it will form water, one molecule of water. So the electrons which are present in the reducing equivalents hand over to final acceptor of this electron is oxygen, and there will be formation of water. This water is called metabolic water. Even in complex pore, when electrons are transferred from one component to another component of complex pore, there is release of energy. So this energy again pushes two proton from the mitochondrial matrix to the intermembranous space. We have FADH2. This is also a reducing equivalent which is coming from the cytoplasm through glycolysis, and also which is generated in TCA cycle. So what is the fate of this FADH2? This FADH2 handovers its high energy electrons to another complex of electron transport chain, which is a peripheral protein called complex 2. So remember, in TCA cycle there is succinate converted to fumarate, where FAD converted to FADH2. Actually this complex linked to TCA cycle, the reaction succinate converted to fumarate. Now this complex also has got iron sulfur complex. It acquires electron from the FADH2 and it will hand over its two electron to coenzyme Q. Then electrons are transferred to complex 3, then to complex 4. Finally, it will hand over to final acceptor oxygen. So with this mechanism, you can understand why NADH plus H plus gives 2.5 ATP, whereas FADH2 gives only 1.5 ATP. Because you can see, the NADH plus H plus, it involves complex 1. So here 4 protons pumped into the intermembranous space. So that is site for 1 ATP. Again in the complex 3, 4 protons, 1 ATP. For generation of 1 ATP, there should be at least 4 protons. And complex 4, there are 2 protons, so 2.5 ATP. Whereas the complex 2, where FADH2 involves complex 2, it bypasses complex 1. There is less of these 4 protons. So we have 4 protons where there is FADH2 involved, and these 2 protons, so 1.5 ATP. So this is exact mechanism of electron transport chain. The oxidative phosphorylation or formation of ATP, I am going to explain in the next video. Thanks for watching.